Dear guests, dear participants, dear colleagues and friends, my name is Oleg Mushkerov, and as a director of the International Center for Mathematical Sciences, Sofia, I'm honored to welcome you to the webinar Women in Southeastern Europe. The answer to the question why we decided to organize this webinar is very simple, because the world needs women. In fact, the world needs math, and math needs our beautiful women, of course. More formally, this event is aimed on promoting European cooperation in mathematics toward enhanced cooperation for women in the mathematical sciences. So we look toward increasing numbers of female faculty members in the mathematical sciences, improving mentorship of female graduate students, and creating vital recruitment mechanism for future female graduate and undergraduate students. The International Center for Mathematical Sciences is generously supported by the Ministry of Education and Science of the Republic of Bulgaria, and here to welcome you today and to open up our webinar is Mrs. Karina Angelieva, Deputy Minister of Education and Science of Bulgaria. So please, Ms. Angelieva, congratulate our participants. Ms. Angelieva?
Thank you very much. Good morning to everyone. For me, it's really great honor, this invitation to open today's event devoted to girls and women mathematicians in mathematics from the Southeastern Europe and overall, globally, because one of my dreams and hobbies during all my 20 years already career in scientific management was basically to support young people with talents, and especially to give the push, the motivation and the special support they need, the ladies that are really motivated, interested and inspired to work in STEM fields, and especially in mathematics and informatics. Why? Because, of course, I'm really a great supporter and friend of the Institute of Mathematics and Informatics, and really one of the praise I wanted to share with you today, and really to thank the great team of this Institute of the Bulgarian Academy of Sciences, is because they not only develop, of course, science of a higher quality, which is very important. The excellence principle in science is the leading principle and should be our goal, of course. But always you have invested so much in mentoring young people to take the steps in scientific career. But also this mentoring includes many other aspects which nowadays one researcher needs. Not very often on the agenda of the politicians and the people funding science, but especially in these dynamic times, we saw it also during the pandemics, the statistics show that unfortunately much more often women drop of science and of entrepreneurial activities than men, of course, because there are many other aspects of the family that they should very often take care. This is also a topic, a discussion that very few research groups dare to take. That's why I'm so proud with the Institute of Mathematics and Informatics, and with the great support of course, of all of you and of Professor Kacakov, Professor Drevsky, of course, it's not any more with us, unfortunately, academician Bogove Sendov. But it's extremely important to talk about women in science. There is not shame. And it's really important debate that is happening in Europe, but sometimes in our society, we just lie comfortably, especially here on the Balkans, and we lie comfortably on the current statistics, which show that, yes, indeed, overall, there is 50-50% involved in different disciplines, men and women. But we shouldn't rest comfortably on this, and we should really still push forward and motivate, and as I said, provide really specific support to girls already in school and later in their stage of career, including also through designing different funding specific measures. So overall, I think today the combination is unique of this event, because first we have this opening of the International Center for Mathematics and Science, which is amazing. Unfortunately, we couldn't have it in situ situation, which would be much more wonderful, of course, because I'm sure that then we'll see this variety of people involved in mathematics, all ages, with all kinds of other skills and talents, as we very well know. But I hope next year we will be able to join. Second, today it's really very important that my country and the Institute of BAS is taking the lead to build this network in the region. Because only through uniting in the region and building critical mass in this specific area, we will show that there is a potential. We are not a periphery of Europe. We can be really leaders. And last but not least, I hope that naming it International Center for Mathematics, and with so many amazing researchers that are today with us from all over the world, we will also showcase that mathematics and fundamental sciences are extremely important, and they have to be on the agenda of the politicians for the next decade. So overall, I want to wish a good work. Success to the event, inspiring, of course, topics, discussions, and I'm looking forward for a better year and really to a great cooperation and support that we can design together with you what's next for mathematics and for the girls and for the region. So thank you once again very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. I hope that we will keep our relations with the ministry in the next year and so on. So you have very close relations with our institute programs. We will develop all these things. Unfortunately, now it is not possible, maybe, or it's dangerous to be together. Otherwise, I would invite you, in the name of the director of our institute, to come here and to see what we have done during this year, I mean in the activities of the International Center. So thank you very much once again for your congratulations to us and so on. So the Institute of Mathematics and Informatics is a significant part of the Bulgarian Academy of Sciences, without whose support our work would be impossible. So I'm happy to welcome academician Julian Rybalski, and I take this opportunity to congratulate him on his re-election as president of the Bulgarian Academy of Sciences last week. Please, academician Rybalski. Julian?
Yeah, I'm hearing you. Dear Mrs. Angelieva, Professor Mushkarov, dear colleagues and participants, thank you very much for this opportunity to congratulate you on behalf of the Bulgarian Academy of Sciences. But before that, I'm also a mathematician, and this was also one of my dreams to have such kind of international center for mathematical study sciences for a long time. So first of all, congratulations for the center that despite this pandemic year, it has had a in my opinion, very good activities due to the energy of Oleg, of Ludmila and Velichka, and in the course of the all colleagues from the Institute of Mathematics and Informatics, which contribute to this center. It has started well, although the year was very, very difficult. And I think that it will continue in this way in the future, in becoming a center which will attract, on one side, very excellent mathematicians, but also young people to come to share the presence of such kind of specialists in our center. Congratulations also for the for organizing this event in order to show to the young people, young girls and pupils, students, the success of some of our colleagues who are women, and in this way to push them to, for a further research. Bulgaria traditionally is the among the young people there are many girls, sometimes there are even more than the boys, who are very successful in the mathematical competitions. So we need to, as Mrs. Angelieva also mentioned, we need to motivate them to continue further with the scientific career, because they can achieve extremely good results, and in this way to promote women in science in general. I think that in this particular issue, we have quite a good success in Bulgaria, and this event will contribute. Thank you very much also for those that agreed to participate and to present their works. I'm sure that these works will be motivation, as I mentioned, to young people to continue pursuing mathematical, scientific mathematical career. So once again, congratulations, Professor Mushkuru, for organizing this, and I wish success to all of the participants and to the meeting. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Academician Revalsky. Special thanks for your efforts, first to create this institute, and then for your help all this difficult year to support us, and of course, we think that the Bulgarian Academy of Sciences is the right place for our international center. So thank you once again. The International Center for Mathematical Sciences is affiliated with the Institute of Mathematics and Informatics of the Bulgarian Academy of Sciences, which is providing the infrastructure for the activities of the center. Now I would like to introduce academician Veselin Drenski, who is the director of the institute. But before giving him the floor, I'm happy to congratulate academician Drenski for his 70th birthday today. On behalf of all participants in our webinar, I want to wish him very, very good health and many more mathematical achievements. Thank you, Academician Drenski, for sharing part of your special day with us today. Happy anniversary, Academician Drenski.
Thank you very much. I also, I'm extremely happy to participate in the opening ceremony here. So I start, dear lady mathematicians, dear ladies who are not mathematicians but are friends of mathematics, dear colleagues and friends. You see, Southeastern Europe, this is something specific part of the world. We speak different languages, but we have the we're the same people. We have the same habits, the same kitchen, you can eat the same dish, all the country has a national dish. We have the same dances, so we are the same people, the only difference is the languages. Since we all are mathematicians, we speak also the same language, the language of mathematics. If you open the statistic, you see that between the First and the Second World War in the States, only 14% of the ladies, of the people defending PhD theses, they are ladies. And this percentage in the States was reached only in the 80s. In Europe, in the European Union, now the percentage of ladies in science, this is 21%, which is much better. But I think that in the Balkans, the situation is even better. If you see our institute as an example, you can see that we have a lot of ladies who are professors. Four ladies chairpersons of the sections, and this is 40%. One deputy director, the scientific secretary, the secretary of the scientific council, they are ladies. We have one editor-in-chief, a lady of a journal, which is in the first 25%. So I think that the situation in Bulgaria, in our institute in Bulgaria and also in the Balkans, is better than in Europe as a whole. And of course, I expect that... this situation will continue, and I expect that all the people will help to this, the ladies, to do successful mathematics. Okay, for the meetings, I want to say bon voyage.
Thank you very much. Now, at the end of our opening, I want to present Professor Ludmil Kacarkov, who is the scientific director of our center, and he will say a few words about the program and the on the of the webinar, and we'll make some announcements. So please, Ludmil.
Good morning. First of all, thank you very much, and welcome to our guests who agreed to participate in this first and annual meeting of women in Southeast Europe. I'm sure that this will be an event that will stay in our calendar forever. And I'm sure next year we will be all together in wonderful city of Sofia. The idea of organizing such a center certainly belongs to Academic Revalsky and Academic Sendov. We are all very grateful to the Ministry of Education and Science for the support, and also to Bulgarian Academy of Sciences, to Karina and to Julian for supporting this wonderful center. And so I'm sure that in the future you'll hear more about it. So as I mentioned, this was an idea really of academician Sendov, who has done miracles for Bulgarian mathematics. So I must say that usually his dreams have the tendency to come true. And recently, his very famous Sendov conjecture, in fact, this week, was proven by very famous mathematician Terence Tao. Of course, event will follow, but let's hope that his dream for our center also materialized as his dreams about the Sendov's conjecture did. And I'm sure this will happen. So once again, this is the first, but I hope an annual event, and I hope to see you next year in Sofia again. So let's move on with our program. First, an announcement. Academician Drensky will present together with his collaborator Bumova a short expose on the life achievements and contribution to Margaret Wolfe, and that will happen tomorrow at 1 o'clock. This is an addition to the program. But now let's move on with the first speaker of today.